Blog Talk Radio.
Hello, welcome to blogtalkradio.com. You are now online with Andrea.
Welcome, everyone. You are now online with Andrea here on Blog Talk Radio. And whether you are on the phone line, on the internet, listening, chatting, or blogging, listening to us live, or reviewing one of our archives, we are so happy to have you with us. Today we are joined by Rodney Jones, one of the best jazz guitarists in the world. And even though he is considered a jazz guitarist, he actually can play anything and has played a wide array of genres, gospel, jazz, traditional, and contemporary, new age, rock, blues, opera, R&B, Broadway, maybe even country. And he has such an incredible list of credits. In fact, we could actually do an entire show just on the credits alone. I'm looking at the list here, and this is not a very comprehensive list, but Dizzy Gillespie, Milt Jackson, Regina Carter, Lena Horne, Kathleen Battle, Tony Bennett, Ruth Brown, Tommy Flanagan, Stan Getz, Wynton Marcellus, Najee, Bonnie Raitt, Ben Vereen, Grover Washington, to name just a few. Welcome, Rodney, to Online.
My pleasure to be here with you today.
Yeah, so who haven't you played with?
Well, that's the million-dollar question, isn't it? Yeah. Well, if variety is the spice of life, I really do have a very varied life. I've been fortunate to have played with many of the masters and famous entertainers in the music industry and in all different styles, partially because I like all different types of music. So I've been very fortunate. I don't know. That is a game. I sometimes with students say, it's a game we play. Who haven't you, sort of like a Where's Waldo, who hasn't Rodney played with? It's difficult. I never played with Miles Davis.
Oh, okay. Wow. But you've played with just about everyone else, so that there's something to be said for that.
Yeah.
Now, you were born in New Haven, Connecticut, and you started playing guitar at age 5, correct?
At age 6.
Age 6. Mm-hmm. So what inspired you to play guitar?
Well, it's an interesting situation. I had a guitar at 6, it's a toy guitar, and about half a year later, my father was given a guitar by his students. He had always claimed he wanted to learn how to play. And, of course, I immediately appropriated this real guitar and began to try to pick out little tunes and things. We moved to New York shortly thereafter, and I took a few folk guitar lessons and found that I seemed to have some ability to play the guitar. So I guess got really good at it in a roughly short period of time. I think it was divinely inspired. If I'm going to go there and keep it absolutely real, I think I was given a gift that was not of my own making, but I think I was given that, and then it was up to me to try to utilize that gift and make something out of it, and that's what I've tried to do my entire career.
Now, who are some of your favorite guitarists?
Bruce Johnson, a guitarist in New York who really provided a foundation of modern guitar playing that served me so well. I studied with him when I was about 14 years old. Kenny Burrell comes to mind, Wes Montgomery, Grant Green, George Benson, Barney Kessel, as well as Andres Segovia and Christopher Parkening and some of the classical guitarists. Grant Green and Wes Montgomery and George Benson have been large influences, along with a lesser-known guitar player named Nathan Page, who was very instrumental in me developing a modern concept for guitar.
What would you say is the greatest moving force behind your music?
Well, I appreciate that question. So often the questions I've received in interviews tend to be much more mundane and superficial, and although I'm happy to answer those, I just want to, to say thank you to you for being one of the few interviews I've ever done. It really asks these kind of questions that probe the surface. Even on my website, I have what's called an inside sounds and an outside sounds, and what we're now talking about is the inside sounds, the story. What what really is the motivating force for my music is what I call the hand behind the hand, which is the ability and the willingness to open myself up as an instrument of spirit to be used to uplift through music. This is something that stands separate and apart from the style of music I'm playing. But, to really try to use music as a means of communication heart-to-heart between myself and the listener, and also recognizing that between each note I play and each note that's heard, there is this spirit, this eternal essence that is flowing between. So you can call it God if you wish. And so I recognize that it's in that space between the music that I perform and what's received where there's the ability to have a transformative experience, that spirit and God is able to use whatever it is offered for its own purposes. So really that's the motivation now. I guess as a young child and initially my motivation was I felt something magical in music. I would listen to a piece of music and felt like I was transported away into a different place and a different time and to places within myself. It freed my imagination to dream and to see things and to envision things that I did not have when I was just not listening to music. So I recognized that there was something very magical about the power of music to open the heart and to open the awareness. And I've been pursuing that journey ever since. And so I would say that it really is this connection with spirit and the desire and the mission or the feeling of purpose, that it's my purpose to use music as an instrument for upliftment. That's my motivating factor.
Thank you so much, Rodney, for joining us today. We do appreciate you and we appreciate your music, and we hope you'll come back.
I look forward to it.
Okay, great. Well, thank you.
My pleasure.
We've been listening to Rodney Jones here on Blog Talk Radio, and you are online with Andrea. My name is Andrea Garrison. I am your host. And to all of you out there in cyberspace, thank you so much for being here online with Andrea. And to all of you out there tuning in to Blog Talk Radio, I'd like to remind you to keep listening to Online with Andrea, as well as the many, many other wonderful programs we have here on Blog Talk Radio.